All right, so this is just a quick breakdown of the things that I keep in my travel Etchr bag that I intend to use for doing art on the go. So I'm primarily interested in ink, sketching with pencil, charcoal, etc., and watercolor. So trying to get all three of those to fit into a small, compact form factor that can be easily taken on travel, taken inside of a carry-on on the plane has been kind of the goal. And I found this bag at the art store and I kind of fell in love with it right away because it kind of satisfied all of my needs. So let's get into it. So to begin, the bag is pretty nice. It's got some nice straps and stuff that can be connected to kind of whatever you need. You can kind of, they're just Velcro. You can open them up, attach them to whatever you need, which I enjoy quite a bit. The size is quite small. It's got like a front pocket here you could use for things. I'm not sure what I would do with that, but I'm sure I could find a use for it. Opening it up, it's got a double zipper, and also along the zipper line here, this is something I really liked. It's actually got like a rubber seal that goes over top, that makes it waterproof, which I'm really all about, especially because I'm keeping watercolor paints in here. So I do want to, and the paintings themselves, of course, would be kept in here. So I really definitely enjoy the thought of even if it got, you know, if it was raining out or it got wet, it would keep the bag safe. So let's pop this open. So it's primarily it only has really two layers to it. It's not the kind of like double layer system that a lot of other bags will frequently have. It's a little simpler than that. It's got a lot of pockets. It's got a lot of layers for keeping stuff. So let's kind of start digging into what I have here. So I guess we'll just kind of work our way from left to right here. So first and foremost, I have just like a normal Sharpie pen, which I like to use. It's a really nice fine point pen. You know, can't really go wrong with Sharpie. It's great for just like inking in general. You know, I also just really enjoy the accuracy of Sharpie pens. They're pretty high quality, and yet really affordable. So I really enjoy that. Next up, I just have this pretty standard, just like ballpoint pen. So this is, I don't know, it's Paper Mate. Finding a ballpoint pen that is reliable is always like what I find to be the biggest challenge. Like I go through ballpoint pens really fast because I'll use one for a little bit and it'll just, you know, it'll crap out on me. And that's always infuriating. I hate when I go to reach for my pen and go to use it and it's not working that day. And that just sucks. This particular specific pen, not just the brand, but like this pen specifically, has been working quite a while for me. It's always like the one I've been reaching for like, I don't know, like 2 years now. And it still continues to perform pretty well for me. So I don't know. Whenever I find a pen that works well for a while, I tend to like hold on to it and not want to let it go because finding one as reliable as this one has been pretty difficult. But you know, it's pretty standard. It's just, you know, it's a ballpoint pen. This pretty much explains everything about it. Moving on next to the pencils, we have, of course, just the pretty typical Staedtler brand pencils. You know, it's the pretty standard ones that you get for like students and whatnot. It's nothing fancy. I try to keep several different hardnesses. So I've got like, you know, I have a pretty heavy duty 7B, of course. And then I'll also get myself like a B, something a little bit less intense, but a little softer. And then finally, a 2H all the way on the other end, which is always nice to have. And I feel like three kind of gets there. But then I also recently accidentally purchased this pencil. So this is a Faber-Castell graphite pencil. And I actually this funny story about this one is I accidentally bought this pencil because I thought it was charcoal, Because they had the graphite pencils right next to the charcoals, and I didn't realize that they were different, and I was kind of just flipping through, and then I just kind of grabbed a medium one, and it wasn't until I got home that I realized it was graphite, and I had been hoping to do charcoal work that night, so that didn't happen. But then I decided, well, I've got this pencil now, I may as well try it out, and I've been pretty happy with it. Like, it's very soft, and I really enjoy. The lead's a lot thicker than the Staedtler's. So I enjoy this one quite a bit now that I've worked with it a little bit. I think it might be my favorite now. So he kind of just goes with those guys. Next up, we move on to the charcoal. So we have three charcoals here. So first and foremost, I've got a white charcoal, which I'm a pretty big fan of. I like always just having a white charcoal on hand for doing highlights and whatnot. You can do a lot of fun things with it. Even doing charcoal on top of watercolor can be an interesting way to add like little extra details and whatnot. Next up, I have two just normal dark charcoals. They're both, I think, mediums. I kind of like to go with the middle ground. The difference between these two, however, is so they're both Faire-Castells. And these actually are ones I then bought on my second trip back to the store after I had accidentally bought this guy. And I picked these ones up because I wanted charcoal, and I realized that like these were side by side, the same price, and I was like, well, what's the difference? So it turns out this one is standard willow, and this one's the compressed charcoal. So they're a little bit different. You can feel like the texture's a little different. This one's like a little grittier and like a little harder. This one's a little smoother, a little softer. So like depending on what kind of textures you want to go for, you'll get different results, of course. So you can see that there's a bit of a difference to the two. I definitely prefer the willow charcoal. I find the compressed charcoal has a lot of bits to it that pick up. It kind of creates a lot of dust, but there are cases sometimes where, when I want some particular like really dark darks, I reach for this guy. Next up, we're getting into the erasers, which I'm a huge fan of. These two here are two of my favorites to work with. So this one, of course, is just a, I think it's a Tombow. I think it's a Japanese brand. So this one's really interesting. It works exactly the same as a mechanical pencil, to put out the eraser. It's kind of fine. It's good for like small detail work, but like still kind of on the larger side, like kind of medium range erasing. But this one is. I found this and immediately was like, I need to own this. So this is, it looks like a charcoal pencil, but you can see it's got on one end, it's pink, and the other end it's white. And this is an eraser that can be sharpened with just a normal pencil sharpener. And this lets you get really fine and really precise. I'll try and hold it up to the camera to see how well that'll focus. It's not focusing very well, but you can get extremely fine pointed with your erasing, and this is excellent for on like sketches and whatnot if you really want to get those details in and get some very precise little highlights and whatnot into your work. So I really like this guy. Then of course we got we have your classic kneadable eraser, which you're probably familiar with. This little tiny normal, it's like rubber eraser, pretty standard stuff. These are refills for the mechanical eraser pen. We got two sticks for smudging the various work and whatnot. So, of course, because you don't want to get necessarily your hands dirty and whatnot. It's a good way to kind of get that smudging in. So of course I always like to keep a couple of these in the case. It's always nice and handy to have. I think that mostly covers that for. I also like to keep a little container for my shavings, just because I don't like to, you know, if I'm out and about and I'm doing any kind of pencil or sketching work, I don't want to litter. So I try to keep all my shavings in one spot. And then I just, you know, and as soon as I walk past a garbage can, I just empty out and put it away. I got the little, pretty standard sharpener. I like to always try and get my sharpeners as small as possible, but I still prefer these small, like these little metal heavy duty ones. I find they last the longest and they give me the most reliable edge. And I think that mostly covers it for sketching. Oh yeah, right. And finally we have a eraser, of course. This is a pretty standard eraser. It's in inches. I think I'd like to get a second one in centimeters as well, if I can find one. But I have two separate rulers for different jobs. Did I say eraser? Should be a ruler. Ruler. It's a ruler. So that's that. Okay. Yeah, I think that's it for the sketching stuff. So now I move on to the watercolor stuff, which I'm quite happy with. So to begin with, we have two travel brushes from Gray Matters. So the first one's just a small round brush. Just, you know, it's pretty straightforward. Nice and small, compact, gets the job done. I don't do like any kind of large scale painting when out and about, so these little brushes get the job done just fine. And then a small flat brush. And these two, I think, are fine enough. They get the job done. I'm happy with them. Next up. So for actually doing the work, I like these small individual palette papers. So this, of course, this is my swatch for combining my colors. I think you might be able to see that moderately well. I like these papers. I don't like having to pull out like an entire book in order to do my work. I like being able to keep things light and kind of breezy and, you know, not very committed. And yeah, it's honestly like it gets the job done. It's fun to do. It's fun to work with. And easy to store. Or, you know, if you want to do a painting and like give it to someone, you don't have to like tear it out of the book or whatever. So honestly, this is my kind of preferred way to do my watercolors. Especially when I'll show you in a few minutes here my kind of fancy setup I have. Keep a couple, these are just like makeup sponges. They're pretty good for like cleaning up paint or kind of just all around useful. You can also use them for like smudging your charcoal and whatnot. They'll get the job done there as well. They're really pretty good for a lot of different purposes, so I like to keep a couple. And then I also, I'm not gonna like pull them out, but I keep a bunch of paper towels in here as well, all bundled up in there, so I can pull those out for cleaning. So I think I've got like five or six bunched up down in there. And I think that covers most of it, and now we can move on to the setup itself for doing my watercolor work, which I have a lot of fun with. So I use stone ground paint is what I've picked up. I really like the fact that they use honey as their binder, one of their binding agents in the their paints. So it's just a small little tin. I'm a fan of these particular colors I picked out. Like Prussian blue is my favorite color. I really like the pearl. I like the pearlescent painting. I'm a huge fan of doing like pearlescents. They're really fun to work with. And I find sometimes the colors can be quite striking. And I have this little guy here that I really enjoy. It's really cute. So this is just like the littlest, tiniest water bottle. It is so small it's basically just a little tiny water spritzer, so I can use this little guy for wetting my paints down. And I've got a little magnet attached to the bottom, so I can just mount it directly onto my palette. Then this is the other piece that I kind of rigged this together myself. So this is a just like a little plastic lid that I took off of the thing, mounted to a magnet and some bobby pins. And I can mount this to the back of my setup like so. And then I can take one of my pieces of paper like so and clip it in. And now I have a little one-handed mobile station that is, you know, fun, and I can have all sorts of fun with it, and it's very easy to work with. Wow. So I can use the pen here, and I can kind of just wet my paints and, you know, do a little bit of work. And just like jump right into it, honestly, and just have some fun with painting with my various colors. Yeah. And then of course, you know, I put a little bit of water in this tin here for cleaning off, and I can use this area for mixing my various colors, and it wipes clean really nice and easy. So yeah, I think that's pretty much covers it. And that's my whole setup. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you have a good day.